So first of all, I'd like to welcome Mr. Atre. Mr. Vivek Atre needs no introduction to this audience. The great thing is now he's part of our board of advisors. So we'll have a big round of applause for that. As part of our second orbit and that initiative of growing 10x, it's a very important thing to also have working on the business rather than working in the business. So as part of that, a very important initiative is to constitute a very august board of advisors. And we welcome Mr. Atre for that. We've been having background discussions on what our goals are, what we really want, where we are heading, etc. And as part of that, making sure that the company is connected to each other and everybody else is connected to everybody else, and we add a human aspect to our growth. We'd like to introduce Mr. Atre and make this discussion and these talking points not just on one-to-many basis, but one-to-one basis or on a group basis, a regular agenda. And as part of that, I'd like to welcome Mr. Atre. I think we've all circulated your introduction to everybody. I think you, in any case, need no introduction. And we look forward to hearing from you. And he'll be talking about aspects around mental health, well-being, and also the importance of hustle as we move forward in our journey. So, sir, welcome.
Thank you. Thank
you very much, Vikram. I won't take much time of yours. I know you're all busy people, and here I am just after lunch talking, giving a speech, and you have to listen to the speech. But I do thank Jitin and Komal for inviting me to speak. Some of you have heard me earlier, many, many years ago. Some of you may have watched the Ranveer show where I appeared by chance twice. And Komal and Jitin have been junior friends, if I can say so, young friends. I've been in touch with them for many, many years. Families have known each other. Today I'm here very happy to be advising your organization, but I'll just spend a few minutes talking about life and goals and how we should work together and how what we're facing. I know all of us are under tremendous pressure today. I don't know why we are under pressure, but we are. And somehow that feeling of being under pressure is always there. That there's some timeline, there's some deadline, there is some target, there's some personal conflict or pressure to manage. There's no cool scene as such. But I do a lot of humorous interventions in my talk. So my first question to you is going to be, how many of you are from Himachal? Please raise your hands. Anybody from Himachal? We have a few over there. Very good, very good. Oh, पीछे से एक हाथ दिख रहा है बस हाँ, okay. There's a person behind the hand and some over here. Very good. Why I'm saying this is because my wife Nina is from Himachal, and I always give due importance to the state of Himachal. I think the coolest people are from Himachal. And they're also cool because of the temperature. But the main thing is, even in this very stressed out era, the only place where you can see people sitting idle, खाली बैठे बिल्कुल बिना फोन के बिना कुछ करे और धूप सेकने के लिए, वो हिमाचली लोग हैं। और इसका ये मतलब नहीं कि वो काम नहीं कर रहे। They are very productive, they are very efficient, they are very polite, and I've been in the government, as you probably know. In the civil services, we have this image that Himachal is a good place to work. And the government is rather honest, comparatively, compared to other states, rather efficient, rather well-oiled. Their e-governance, the IT enablement of the government is also pretty good. The police is good. You may have also heard of the police band of Himachal appearing on Kaun Sa Show? India's Got Talent, exactly. So the Himachal police band appeared over there and won some awards. Mr. Sanjay Kundu, the DGP of Himachal Police, and he's a Kashmiri, he's a good friend. So he also told me about that. Why I'm saying that is, all the Delhi wala, Chandigarh wala, Punjab wala, Haryana wala need to learn from the Himachalis. And it's not a rule, there could be exceptions. They can be a cool person in Delhi, though there may be few, But there's someone who's calm, serene, unruffled, no pressure, anand mein rehte hain type of thing. They may be in Delhi 1, 2, 3, 4%. Right? 1 or 2, 3, 4%. In Himachal, they might be 50%. But in every place, we have people under pressure. Abhi Socrates ka quote bhi ho jaye because I'm a speaker, so I have to justify my speaking abilities. Abhi tak to main gappe maar raha hu. Socrates said, beware the barrenness of a busy life. Socrates was a Greek philosopher. Everybody over the centuries has been quoting Socrates only. Abhi tak Socrates, jaise purane gaane Lata Mangeshkar ke never die out. That is how Socrates' quotes will never die out. Beware the barrenness of a busy life. Means what? Busy life is a banjar zameen. Ab Punjab Haryana mein aapko pata hai banjar zameen kya hoti hai, jisme kuch nahi grow karta. So busy life mein nothing is really sprouting out of it. We are working, we are busy. Where is the day gone? Where is the life gone? Where is the year gone? What really emerged from it? Apart from the work that we did, apart from the targets we achieved, but what did we exactly do? What did we enjoy? What were the highlights? We may not even ponder to think. So the thing is that we need to take these pause moments in life. Reflect. Where are we headed? What is the goal? If I ask you very bright people, what is the goal? So who will tell me in one word, what is the goal of your journey? One word. Yes? Peace. Very good answer. Who said that? Great answer. Peace is a great answer. P-E-A-C-E wala peace. Not P-I-E-C-E wala peace. We don't go to pieces. Peace within. But that is a very philosophical thing, spiritual, which will come to. So, thoda sa usse niche. Peace is the ultimate goal. Little lower than that, what could it be?
Satisfaction.
Okay, satisfaction is a good answer, yes. Satisfaction, contentment, fulfillment, ये सब एक जैसे words हैं. तो हमें जो भी हमने किया उससे हमें संतुष्टि मिली. We are like cool, satisfied with what we did. So we are happy about that. Happiness is probably a better word to describe what. You know which country has a happiness index score? Which country?
Scandinavian, right?
Norway?
Norway or
Bhutan?
Bhutan, yes.
Bhutan, and the highest. You're right. The highest happiness index is in the Scandinavian countries, Norway and all. But the official GDP has been replaced by the goal of happiness index in Bhutan. Okay, the GDP is nonsense. Economic benefit without happiness growing is of no consequence. So ultimately, the goal is happiness. Now, happiness can come from Golgappa also. Yahan pe milte honge kahin aaspaas. What do we call Golgappa in other parts of the country?
Water balls.
Water balls. Water balls. Water balls. Pani puri. One more. One more in Rajasthan, Bengal. Puchka. But the taste is pretty much the same. Ek Golgappe wala yahan pe khada hota hai, Saint Kabir School ke paas. Yeah? Okay. So she knows. The Golgappa man who I wrote about, he's been standing there for the last maybe 20 years. The man is now older. He's very simple. He has a jar of water and a dabba, gattega, and normally people who work in top companies will not stop there. Because the rickshaw wala, the cycle labor wala will stop there. Because he's got a unhygienic looking place. You will go to a better place or you will order from Swiggy or something, but that place is not for you. I used to cross him in my red light wali gari, and that I would look at him every day, tempted to stop and have his Golgappas, but officers in IAS are not supposed to stop and have Golgappas on the roadside. Where you come? 4 saal ho gaye, 5 saal ho gaye, 6 saal ho gaye. But this man was always smiling. So happiness to him was coming from the Golgappas. But what was it that made him so happy? I was wondering all these years, why does this man smile so much? What is his goal? What is the secret? So then I realized that mental wellness, happiness, peace, everything he has, but he's poor. His Golgappas can't give him too much income because the lower income people are stopping there. He can't be charging much for them. He can't be giving mineral water like Golgappas. Normal party. Now, why is he so happy? So then, one day I wrote an article in the Tribune, the Golgappa man, wrote about him. Laminate karke one day I stopped the car. So I went up to him, I said, aapke bare mein maine kuch likha hai. So he looked at the car, he thought, main uski ready uthane ke liye aaya. To wo ghar kar gaya, thoda he wasn't smiling that day. Every day he used to smile, when I came, he wasn't smiling. He was a bit scared. I said, देखो मैं आपकी रेडी उठाने नहीं आया, वो कोई और आएगा एक दिन, लेकिन वो भी नहीं आएगा क्योंकि मैं आपके साथ हूँ, I'll tell him not to come. तो थोड़ा सा कॉन्फिडेंस आया, my driver was also there, तो उसने उसको थोड़ा समझाया कि साहब ठीक ठाक है, डरने की कोई बात नहीं. So I gave him that article, I explained it to him, कि I praise you in this, that you are a smiling person, and I want you to keep this article also, and what is it that makes you so happy? Ask you that. He says, साहब क्या डरने की क्या बात है? कुछ तीन बच्चे हैं, उनकी शादी वादी हो जाएगी, कितनी इनकम है, बैंक में कोई पैसा है? नहीं, कुछ नहीं, हैंड टू माउथ है, लेकिन हो जाएगा. कैसे हो जाएगा? बस मुझे भरोसा है. किस पे भरोसा है? अपने पे, ऊपर वाले पे. So the attitude was not casual. एक होता है casual, एक होता है कि he was just serene, peaceful in his mind, had faith in his abilities to work hard, and the children also probably assisting him or something. So I realized from him that having money or power or fame is not going to give that much happiness. On the other side of the spectrum, we have Donald Trump. Ab ye video unko to nahi bhej rahe aap, kyunki unki main burai karne wala hu. A man who was the most powerful man in the world and one of the richest never smiles, grumpy has been replaced in the dictionary by the word trumpy. Now we don't say grumpy, we say trumpy. It nahi hai, it's a joke hai. Point kya hai ki Trump is someone who is at the other end of the spectrum but never knows how to be happy. So what is the secret here? Where does happiness lie? Where does this answer come from? What are we looking for? Of course, we want a car, we want a bit of stature, we want some fame, some social media following. When we go somewhere, people may say, "Acha, ha, to wahan pe kaam karte ho, you're very bright," or whatever. Or you're from my college, I used to follow you. Or you know, you have a younger sibling, a cousin, or somebody who looks up to you, bhaiya, didi, you know. That is good recognition. And we have a bit of power, किसी को जानते हैं, उसको फोन कर दिया, भैया ये काम करा देना, उसने करा दिया, ठीक है, very good. And we have a reasonable income where we can buy a car, a house, etc. That much we need. But how will we find happiness in that route? What are we searching for? I think some people, they are searching more for fulfillment in their work and the satisfaction of having achieved something which they set out to achieve. कि ये मेरा प्रोजेक्ट था, इसमें मुझे ये सक्सेस मिला, ये वो ज्यादा हाई है कंपेयर टू द मटेरियल बेनिफिट्स दैट वी गेन आउट ऑफ इट. तो काम की सेटिस्फैक्शन प्लस अ सर्टन जॉय इन द हार्ट इज व्हाट वी प्रोबेबली नीड. व्हाट अबाउट बराक ओबामा? स्माइलिंग फेस. बराक ओबामा स्माइलिंग पर्सन इन द सेम पोजिशन एज ट्रंप. अभी 8 साल हो गए तो खाली बैठे हो. He can't be the president anymore, right? India में ऐसा कोई limit नहीं है. वहाँ पे 8 साल के बाद छुट्टी. But Barack Obama exemplified that kind of attitude in power also, which was cheerful, radiant. His happiness is not coming from being president. His happiness is coming from within. So my book is called Family. My book is called Finding Success Within. So where do we find this success? Success is a word which you did not mention when I asked you what is the goal. Ultimately, the goal is success, but success is about inner peace and happiness. Ab jo 22, 24, 26, 28 years ka hai, usko ye bolo ki the goal of life is happiness and not money and not you know, material benefits is a bit odd. I can understand that. But we all went through that route. कुछ जम करके तो I didn't reach here where I am. I come through that route, right? हम भी कॉलेज में पढ़ते थे, हम भी सब कुछ करते थे. तो realize क्या करना है कि a person with who is 16 years old, he or she admires people with luxuries. 16 में admires हो लंबोगरी है इसके बाद यार छाले बंदा. गाना भी है लंबोगरी. What is it that a person who has seen a bit of life aspires for? Of course, some people, they never grow up. उनके पास लंबोगरी भी है तो उनको और चाहिए लंबोगरी. ये वाला वर्जन आ गया तो वो वाला चाहिए. बट देर आर सम पीपल हु रियलाइज लेटर इन लाइफ दैट ऑल द मनी इन द वर्ल्ड वोंट बाय मी हैप्पीनेस. सो वेयर इज माय माइंड. अब मैं आईआईटी मद्रास भी जाता हूँ, वीआईटी वेलोर भी जाता हूँ, बिट्स पिलानी गोवा भी गया था, आईएएस एकेडमी में भी जाता हूँ, कॉर्पोरेट्स में भी जाता हूँ. आई एम अ स्पीकर, सो आई विल स्पीक ऑन दीज टॉपिक्स. सो द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस एरा ऑफ योर डोमेन, your mindset at this point is overthinking. How many of you are into overthinking, by the way? Raise your hands. But nidar hoke karo na, matlab isme koi darne ki baat. Koi dekh to raha nahi hai ki bhai ab HR wale dekh rahe hain ki overthinking kaun kaun kar raha hai, inke number kaato. Aisa nahi hai. Everybody is overthinking. Everyone is overthinking. Because we are Instagram. Instagram encourages overthinking. Ki main kyun nahi hoon aisa? Feel good factor. The feel good factor that somebody has, why is it not mine? So I'm overthinking. How do I get there? How do I compare with Jacqueline Fernandez or Hrithik Roshan or Virat Kohli or Cristiano Ronaldo or Justin Bieber ya jo bhi hai? Main kaise wahan pe pahunchungi? So overthinking is the bane. Bane pata hai? B-A-N-E, bane. Drawback of this era. So this drawback of this era is that we are comparing ourselves with others and searching for happiness in that material benefit. Can I look better? Can I be better at earning money? Can I be more popular? Can I be more powerful? That's what I'm looking for. But here we need to look for satisfaction, happiness in other things. What about friendship? अब जो कॉफी के ऊपर जो हमारी गपशप होती है किसी के साथ भी, उसका कोई जवाब नहीं है. वो जो मेमोरेबल मोमेंट्स यू स्पेंड इवन विद योर ग्रैंड मदर, नानी, मदर, फादर, चिल्ड्रन, वन डे फ्रेंड्स, लव्ड वंस, देयर इज नो मैच टू दैट. सो लेटर इन लाइफ व्हेन यू लुक बैक यू रिमेंबर ऑल द गुड थिंग्स यू डिड. But you also remember all those sparkling, happy moments which you spent with your loved ones and your friends. So we look forward to that kind of happiness. And it doesn't come from that extra buck or that extra power or that extra social media appreciation. वो blue ticks आए या नहीं आए कुछ खास बात नहीं होनी चाहिए. But वो है, नहीं? उसने अभी तक like नहीं किया post. So we become besotted, that means obsessed, by that kind of aim and goal, which should not be our goal. We should enjoy the peace with it. But we are human. Koi perfect to nahi hai. Can anyone say that I am perfect? Or had the smoothest life ever in the history of the world? You never lost your mobile. Nobody ever said anything bad to you. Kabhi aapko chot nahi lagi. कभी किसी ने इंसल्ट नहीं किया. ऐसा तो कभी नहीं होता. कुछ ना कुछ तो होता है ना लाइफ में गड़बड़. सो वी नीड टू विन दैट इनर कामनेस बैटल विच इज फ्रॉम आवर एटीट्यूड. वो एटीट्यूड किसका है, वो कहां से आएगा? एक ही सिचुएशन में दो आदमी, एक खुश और एक दुखी, एक रोंदू टाइप और एक खुश मिजाज हसमुख, एक दुखी आत्मा or a cheerful. Where does it come from? You heard of Arunima Sinha? Who heard of Arunima Sinha? Arunima Sinha, yes. Kaun hai? Yes, yes. He's right. volleyball player who lost her legs in a train decollete. She wanted to be an India volleyball player. Lost her legs. Could not play. Got prosthetic limbs, artificial limbs, and started climbing, started trekking, walking, and then started climbing mountains, and ultimately scaled Mount Everest on artificial legs. And wrote a book now. Ab Arunima Sinha ko to pareshani hui na, mushkil hui. She had a big problem to overcome. Most of us should actually be grateful for what we have. If we have that kind of attitude when we don't have any major problem in life, hoti sabhi ko hai. Aisa nahi ki problem kisi ko hi, maine bola ki perfect life kisi ki nahi hai. Lekin some of the problems that we have, they may not be major compared to Arunima or anyone else. So we need to be grateful and move forward. We move forward out of frustration is not the right way. We move forward out of a sense of contentment. कि ये अभी तक जो चल रहा है ठीक है, इससे बेहतर मुझे करना है. ये नहीं कि मेरे अभी तक 35 रन बने हैं, मुझे 65 बनाने अगली बार. दैट इज ओके. बट इफ आई फील टू फ्रस्ट्रेटेड, टू लो, टू बैड अबाउट माई ओन अचीवमेंट्स, आई एम क्रिटिसाइजिंग माई ओन सेल्फ, आई एम ओवर थिंकिंग अबाउट माई ड्रॉबैक्स, देन दैट्स नॉट द वे टू मूव फॉरवर्ड. सी नाउ दे आर ऑल लिसनिंग टू मी वेरी क्लियरली. शुरू में थोड़ा सा स्केप्टिसिज्म था कि ये पता नहीं, स्केप्टिसिज्म पता है, मतलब डाउट था कि ये बंदा ठीक भी है या नहीं. अभी सब लोग सुन रहे हैं ध्यान से. अभी मैं टेडेक्स टॉक देके आया, वहां पे बिट्स पिलानी कैंपस गोवा में. द टॉपिक वाज एआई वर्सेस द ह्यूमन एलिमेंट. एआई इज योर फोर्टे. एआई इज रियली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. कोमल जितिन एंड आई वर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट. बट इन दैट एरा ऑफ एआई, आई एम अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. हमारे पास तो दिल है. सो दैट दिल हैज ऑल्सो टू बी लुक्ड आफ्टर. वॉट रियली मेक्स मी टिक, एंड कैन आई नोटिस द पर्सन नेक्स्ट टू मी दैट टूडे शी और ही इज फीलिंग लो, और एम आई गोइंग टू बी एन ऑटोमेटॉन गोइंग फॉरवर्ड. चिप भी आ जाएगा रिस्ट में, यहां पे भी. डरने की तो बात नहीं है, वी वी आर पार्ट ऑफ दैट एरा. एंड इवन देन आई विल बी ह्यूमन. So can I notice this person and say, what happened to you today? You are a little looking as if you're not well or feeling low. What happened? That's a human element. So that human being factor has to be within us. We need to appreciate others, encourage others, empathize with others, be compassionate. What ultimately is the goal? Happiness. And what ultimately is the earning of life? Ye bhi jawab chahiye mujhe. Goal of life is happiness. अर्निंग क्या है? मेमोरीज. वेरी गुड. ये वाला जो आंसर है उनको पता है कि ये टेंजिबल आंसर नहीं है कि इतनी चीजें, ऐसी चीजें, ये वाला घर, ये वाली कंबाइन, वो वाला वो. नो, मेमोरीज इज अ ग्रेट आंसर. आई वुड से अनदर थिंग इज गुडविल. कि यार वो बंदा ठीक है, कुछ भी, बंदा बढ़िया है. What, how do you earn that? You earn that by being human, humane. You add an E to human, it becomes humane. Humane, so you are a person with a humane approach, humanitarian approach. You care for others, you listen to others, you are considerate to others, not only self-centered. Wo kehte hain, the universe conspires to help those who help others. So if you are of an helpful attitude, you will get good will. What about the organization you work for? If we do well personally, then the organization also does well. But if I am trying to put someone down and make myself go higher at the cost of someone else, then the organization may suffer. What about a sports team? Hockey, cricket. Chak De India, you all remember? When you were born, it was probably made 2003, 2004, 2005 or something. Huh? Some of you were very, very young. Chak De India mein kya hota hai? Wo do forwards hoti hain. Wo ek dusre ko goal nahi karne dena chahti, khud hi goal karna chahti hai. One was from Chandigarh and one was from Haryana, I think, in that movie. Our personality bhi different hoti hai, tall and thin and one short and tiny. And they were competitors. Or ultimately, only when they worked as a team, then India won. But when they were fighting with each other or jealous of each other, it didn't work. So the organization ke liye bhi hume goodwill tab milta hai jab hum team player bante. We'll talk about that some other day also. But basically, what I'm trying to say is that we grow when the organization grows when we grow. And we cannot be in isolation. Isolation mein jo success hota hai, wo kam hota hai. Kaun kaun meditation karta hai? Okay, very good, very good, very good. Some people meditate, very good. Now, meditation mein hum bolte hai ki group meditation is very important. If you meditate alone, it's good. But if you meditate in a group, then the vibe, the energy of the other people also come to you. And you grow more. कहने सुनने से नहीं है, वो वैसी एनर्जी है रूम में. So group meditation is like teamwork. When you go somewhere, you feel the vibe. The vibe is your world. That is your generation's world, not my generation's world. But I know it because I am a speaker. I have to talk about the vibe. Now, ये vibe इस hall में है अभी. That vibe is something which cannot be matched by a vibe in a place where people are selfish. अब आप मॉल में जाओ तो सब अपने अपने मिले ना. Everybody is thinking of his own shopping, his own food, his own vibe. वहां पे कोई homogeneous vibe तो नहीं है. बट आप अगर क्रिकेट टीम में जाओ जो अच्छी टीम है, या आप किसी ऐसी कंपनी में जाओ where people are, you know, working together and they're bonding together, then the vibe is better. Now here the vibe is great at the moment. I can feel it because I can perceive the interest in what I'm saying and then the energy is there. These things don't come from what you say. They come from what you are. And what are you? Are you the body, the mind, or the soul? The one who said peace. Are we body, mind, or soul? Soul. Jo peace bolenge, wo soul bhi bolenge. The soul, chalo wo spiritual baat hogi. But at the practical level, we are what we think. Whatever you think, that is what you are. The vibe you emit is a result of your mindset. Ab wo mindset jo hai wo negative bhi ho sakta hai, positive bhi ho sakta hai, usme khichdi bhi ho sakti hai. Jealousy bhi ho sakti hai. Positivity bhi ho sakti hai, negativity bhi ho sakti hai. Guilt bhi ho sakti hai, anger bhi ho sakta hai. Thoughts and minds are very complex, very complex. Can we improve? अभी हमने बोला कोई परफेक्ट नहीं है, किसी की लाइफ 100% स्मूथ नहीं है, बट कैन वी इंप्रूव आवर माइंडसेट? श्योरली वी कैन बी मोर पॉजिटिव देन बिफोर, वी कैन बी हैप्पियर देन बिफोर, वी कैन बी मोर अवर टीम प्लेयर देन बिफोर, वी कैन बी मोर अवर एम्पैथेटिक पर्सन देन बिफोर. ये सब तो हो सकता है. आई यूज्ड टू बी समवन हू यूज्ड टू लूज माय टेंपर क्वाइट अ लॉट. आई वाज इन सर्विस, स्कॉर्पियो मेरा बर्थ साइन है, तो एकदम से स्पाइक ऑफ एंगर. एंड देन आई यूज्ड टू थिंक ये तुम्हारा राइट है. उसका कारण दो कोमल एंड जितने नियम नहीं बनाए देव इन कॉलेज एंड ऑल, आई वाज इन ऑफिस एंड तब इन्होंने देखा नहीं होगा मुझे गुस्सा करते हुए, बट आई यूज टू काम डाउन विद इन टू मिनट्स, विच वॉज नॉट अ गुड थिंग. बैड थिंग वॉज द स्पाइक. बट नाउ आई रियलाइज कि उसका कोई ना फायदा है ना बेनिफिट, कुछ भी नहीं है. तो आई रियली काम डाउन. ऑफ कोर्स मेडिटेशन, स्पोर्ट्स, मोटिवेशनल स्पीकिंग, ऑल दीज थिंग्स हेल्प मी आल्सो. सो आई फील इंस्पायर्ड बाय यू. यू मस्ट फाइंड समथिंग टू इंस्पायर यू. ये कोई डल रूटीन लाइफ का फायदा नहीं है ना, कोई तो जोश चाहिए. सो लास्टली आई आस्क यू वन ऑर टू क्वेश्चन. वो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू सो सैम बहादुर बाय द वे? नॉट बैड, नॉट बैड. When I go across India, I see about 10% people. Yahan pe around 30, maybe 25% people raise their hands. How many of you saw Animal? Komal, I must congratulate you. Kyunki jitne logon ne Animal dekhe, utno nahi Sam Bahadur. So Sam Bahadur ka aapka homework hai. Please watch it. Why? Because Animal dekhi, aap mujhe koi aapse gila nahi. I have no grouse. I don't think you gained anything much from that. But Sam Bahadur you will gain. So please watch. So inspire yourself by indulging in activities which are more, and sports is a great thing also. Sports is very inspiring. Music. I mean, Instagram ke benefits bhi hain. Now I watched a couple of music performances, so they keep popping up, right? André Rieu, French, Austrian music composer, mesmerizing performance, thousands of people, unka orchestra baj raha hai, people are crying with emotion during the performance. I never knew about such things, and now I watch, I listen. So my mindset becomes peppy, motivated because of performances like that. Or you watch Dinesh Karthik playing multi-multi shots, 84 in 39 balls. Fantastic, yeah. And he's about 37, 38 years old. Dhoni is 40 years old, 42. And Dhoni made 20 in how many balls? Four balls. Six. Ek covers mein six. Ek mid-on mein six. Ek square leg mein six. Or ek double. Yehi tha na. So the thing is, these things, something has to inspire. It can be the World Cup wala, it can be Dhoni, it can be Donald Trump, Barack Obama, it can be anyone like that. Also inspire each other. In each other's success, you find happiness. That is a great sign of goodwill. You feel that bonding. Kal ek IAS mein aaya na ladka, wo topper of India. Uska video aaya. Video aaya na uska. वो आईपीएस में था और उसके आईपीएस के फ्रेंड्स ने उसको जाके बताया कि यू हैव टॉप्ड द नेक्स्ट एग्जाम, यू आर नाउ इन द आईएएस, एंड दैट बॉन्डिंग, दैट कैमरादरी व्हिच इज देयर इन दैट, यू सी दैट वीडियो हाउ ही रिएक्ट्स टू द न्यूज ऑफ हिज सक्सेस. सो आई थिंक आई हैव स्पोकन लॉन्ग इनफ एंड आई थिंक इट्स टू मच फॉर वन डे. सो अभी जो बातें हैं यही बहुत है अभी तक. सो एनी टेक अवे फ्रॉम दिस टॉक, एनी वन वर्ड, टू वर्ड्स, सॉरी मैं क्वेश्चन भी पूछता रहता हूँ, तो कोई टेक अवे है तो बताओ. बी हैप्पी, ओके, डू नॉट ओवरथिंक, वेरी गुड, फाइंड इंस्पिरेशन, मेक मेमोरीज,
मेक
गुडविल. एक और लेसन है, एक जितिन को शेरों का शौक है तो मैं भी एक शेर सुना देता हूँ. मैं आई हैव नॉट रिटन दिस एंड वी डिस्कस्ड इट अर्लियर. This is about meditation actually, but it is basically fitur hota hai har daur mein juda juda. Fitur means passion, daur means era, juda juda means alag alag. Fitur hota hai har daur mein juda juda, pehle khilone, phir ishq, phir paisa, phir khuda khuda. So we clap for Mark Zuckerberg. Why for Mark Zuckerberg? Clap. Why? Because I got it from WhatsApp anonymously, so we credit it to the owner of WhatsApp. वो जो तो आपको पता ही है ना कि जकरबर्ग की मम्मी उसको बोलती है कि ज़्यादा टाइम लगाओ WhatsApp पे और Facebook पे और Instagram पे, और कोई मम्मी नहीं बोलती. The point is that this is what life is. Toys, crushes, career, खुदा खुदा बाद में बारी आई या नहीं आई God की. So bring God in now. When the crushes are there, bring in God right now. Right now. Career भी चलेगा, क्रशिंग भी चलेगी, गॉड को भी ले आओ. मेडिटेशन, देयर इज द लास्ट सेंटेंस, प्रेयर इज अस टॉकिंग टू गॉड, मेडिटेशन इज गॉड टॉकिंग टू अस. सो वी हैव टू रिसीव द वाइब ऑफ गॉड राइट नाउ. विच एवर रिलीजन, फॉलो योर रिलीजन, डू योर मेडिटेशन, बी थैंकफुल, ग्रेटफुल. So that was my motivational speech. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Anyone want to say anything? वैसे आपने अच्छे जवाब दिए जो मैंने questions पूछे. Thank you for the participation. And what I really liked was that people's interest levels went from being, let's say, average to high.
Yes, I saw that.
You could see that because you're standing here. The eyes were lighting up. The smiles were
brighter.
Smiles
were coming.
पहले पता नहीं होता ना कि कौन है, क्या चीज है. अब रणवीर शो भी देख लेना इसके
बाद.
नहीं नहीं, लेट्स एडमिट इट, दे मे नॉट, कोई जरूरी, मुझे कोई वो नहीं है, भ्रम नहीं है मुझे. सो यू वॉच द रणवीर शो, वॉच, फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम एंड वॉच द रील्स व्हिच आई मेक अबाउट रीडिंग बुक्स, अबाउट माइंडफुलनेस, अबाउट क्रिकेट, वेरियस थिंग्स. सो यू विल बी इन टच. ओके. Okay?
And I think he was talking about vibes today. You personify good vibes.
Thank you so much.
You know, I'm feeling so much better.
Thank you.
You know, we all come in so busy in the morning. It's so important to have positivity, you say teamwork, and happiness. And I think good vibes is something that you really brought to the office today. We're so looking forward to having him regularly in the office, talking to us, making us better human beings, making us happier human beings. So thank you so much.
Plus, Komal and Jitin appeared on my Good Vibes show.
Yes, please watch
please
that.
Please watch that on YouTube. The Good Vibes show episode number, I don't remember which one. Abhi 30 pe pahunch gaya, 30 pe pahunch gaya. So, I think it was about 19 or something.
So yeah. Thanks to the social media presence, it was the most good vibe show. Second most watched
good vibe show. Thank you guys.
Thank you. Thank you so much.